Hello and welcome to AIC Off-Road Videos. This video will not be about my Jeep or off-roading. I've only driven it a few times since my last video. I have just been super busy and the stalling issue that it's had has gotten worse, and I just haven't had time or money to address it yet. However, I have been busy with vehicles, with cars. If you see my video channel before, you knew that I had a 2005 Infiniti G35. I really liked that car. That was a nice car. However, I recently sold it, and that's kind of prompted this next group of videos. I'm sorry, you're going to get to see a lot of my new to me car and get to listen to me talk a bit. But I want to talk about a few things that I'm kind of passionate about when it comes to cars. First one is, why would you sell a car? Like, what is the point at which you make that decision to sell a car? The next one is, what kind of car should you buy? So going off that first step, what prompted me to sell my Infiniti? Really like the car. It was driving real nice. I put some good amount of money into it, fixing the suspension, fixing some of the electronics. There were a few reasons that kind of totaled up to me making that decision. This part of the decision was, I'd owned it about 18 months and I'd put over 30,000 miles on it. I drive a lot, and it's really hard to keep a car nice when you drive as many miles as I do in a short amount of time. There's a lot of maintenance that comes in with that. There's a lot of things that just break due to the mileage. I do an oil change every 2 to 3 weeks just because I hit 30,000 miles so fast. Or not 30, excuse me, 3,000 miles so fast. And one of the things that comes along with driving a car that much is you just destroy the value of the vehicle. And I got a good deal on it, at least what I thought was a good deal. But from the time that I bought it, the time that I sold it, in that 18 months, I'd lost over $2,500 in value in 18 months. And that's a good amount of money to lose on a car in that amount of time, especially a used car with low miles. I sold it with 180. I bought it with about 150. So yeah, 30,000 miles in less than 18 months. So that was part of it. The other part was even though I'd spent some time fixing it up, getting things working on it, it needed more work. Need quite a bit more work, especially in the last few months. Not even the last few, like the last month and a half, it developed a pretty serious exhaust leak. The horn quit working. The two passenger side windows were working intermittently. The driver's side automatic down had quit working. There was a clunk in the front suspension. I just, despite replacing every piece of it and going through it and even having dealership look at it, and paying them good money to look at it, I just could not get rid of that clunk in the front suspension, and it was really bothering me. And the last thing, and her car is not here right now, but we my wife and I bought her car, the car she's driving right now, about 6 months ago, and we had a goal to pay it off within 10 months. So we were just chucking every single penny we could at it. And we were down to just the last couple thousand dollars, and it's been 6 months, and I'm like, look, if I can come up with $2,000, we can pay your car off and be done, and we'll be done 4 months earlier than we planned. And I said, I looked at the value of my Infiniti, and it was paid off. I paid for it, and what I could sell it for, I could sell it and buy something else and put that money towards paying off her car. And that's exactly what I did. That was the deciding factors. I'm like, I'm putting a ton of miles on the car. It's quite broken in certain ways that aren't, you know, don't necessarily affect the drivability, but they definitely affect, you know, my convenience factor of the vehicle. And so that's what pushed that decision to sell the car, was to pay off my wife's car. And my wife and I are now officially debt free except for our home. And we're huge Dave Ramsey listeners, so, you know, it is a very good feeling. It's something I recommend. So when you decide to sell a car, it needs to be a thought out process. You know, I gave you my reasons. Whether you agree with my reasons or not doesn't matter. They were my reasons. They were what I wrote down on a piece of paper that I could point to these specific things and say, yeah, I would get more value selling it and buying something else than keeping this vehicle and putting money into it. So I sold it. I got what I got for it. I think if I'd held out a little bit longer, I could have gotten a few hundred dollars more, but not a whole lot more. Because like I said, I drove the crap out of that thing. And when I checked 3 months ago, it was worth almost $1,000 more than what it was worth now, simply because of the miles I'd put on it. And I got more than what its Kelley Blue Book private party was. Fortunately, I didn't have a lot of good competition. I kept my car pretty nice. And I paid half of what I got for that car for this car. This is a 2003 Oldsmobile Alero. I paid a little over $2,000 for it. And it's got 80,000 less miles on it than my Infiniti had. So it has just over 100,000 miles. It's got a V6 with 110 less horsepower than the Infiniti had. Almost 130 less horsepower than the Infiniti had. It was 170 versus, I think, 295 for the Infiniti. It's in really good nick, especially this side. If you come to this side, it's got some faded paint because we're in Arizona and paint just, if you don't wax your car and you park it in the sun, don't take care of it, it'll do this paint fading thing. That's where there's still clear coat, and this is where there's no more clear coat. My Jeep's the same way. It's kind of funny, this is actually a similar color to my Jeep. So what made me choose this particular car? Well, I've actually owned an Alero before. I had an 04 Alero that when I was living, I was actually living even further out than I do now. And I was putting 60,000 miles I was putting 60,000 miles every 6 months on a car. So I was buying cars and selling them within 6 months. Because I was just putting so many miles on, it wasn't worth keeping them longer than that. And a lot of times I didn't put any money into them, repairing them or fixing them up or anything. The Alero I did, I ended up putting wheels and shocks and brakes and a water pump, if I remember correctly, on it. But some of them I didn't put any money into. But I really liked the Alero because it was actually very reliable. It was fairly comfortable and fairly fuel efficient. And I like the way it looks. I think it, you know, for an inexpensive car, I think it looks fairly nice. Also, parts, super cheap, ridiculously cheap for this car. And so it was a fairly easy decision for me to pick an Alero. Why did I not buy a new car or a newer car? Well, the whole reason for getting rid of my Infiniti was to become debt free. That was kind of a quote unquote sacrifice that I made to become debt free. And it's so much nicer to be debt-free than have a nicer car, in my opinion. You know, other people, obviously, many, 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 many other people choose otherwise, you know, buying brand new cars and you know, putting them on payments, and which I have done in the past. I've bought two brand new cars in my life, and I've bought several cars, like my wife's car was not brand new, and put it on payments. But in this time of my life, I'm done with that. I've made the decision to no longer have debt. And so I bought a car that I could pay cash for, that I knew a little bit about repair wise and just the overall history of the vehicle and overall reliability of the vehicle, and something I already knew I liked. You know, I had one before, I figured I'd like this one. My previous one was a four-cylinder, it was a V6. A little bit more horsepower, very similar fuel economy, so I went with the V6 when I bought it. When you go to make the decision, just like when you make the decision to sell the car, it needs to be logical and not emotional. Every time you make an emotional decision financially, you're going to come out short end of the stick. You need to sit down and write out what your needs are and what your wants are. What I needed was a car that got 30 miles to the gallon, or as close to it as possible. I needed something that could fit at least four adults. I needed something that could fit some junk in the back, because I sometimes have to, for work, carry stuff around with me. I was thinking about buying a truck, but I don't need a truck. I'd like a truck, but I don't need a truck. And a truck wasn't in my budget. I wanted something with as close to or below 100,000 miles as possible, because I want to keep this car a little bit longer. I'm still driving a lot of miles, but if I can keep this 3 or 4 years and get up to that 160,000 to 180,000 miles before I get rid of it, that'll make me a happy camper. And so I sat down and I really went through a list of cars. And especially in Arizona, there's a lot of cars with salvage titles that you can buy that fit that. And I didn't want a salvage car, a salvage title car. I've had a number of them, and there's usually something. The thing that I find most often on them is they have terrible wind noise when you're driving on the freeway, and that drives me crazy. Even if they're perfectly, you know, the repair was done near perfect on them, they almost always have wind noise. And I really narrowed it down to a few cars, but I kept coming back to the Alero, having owned one before. Nothing wrong with buying a car you've already owned one of, you're familiar with it. But it needs to be logical. It needs to be a decision that's made with your brain and not your heart or your gut, and because a salesman tells you to do it. I actually had to get a part for my wife's car, just minor repair, $35, went to the dealership, pick it up. And while I was there, the salesperson was like, oh, come look at the new cars, you know, look at the new cars, you traded in your car, it's paid off, let's get you into a new car, there's equity in your car, blah, 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 whatever. And I thought about it after coming home. I completely blew him off because I wasn't going to look at a new car. I'm happy with my car. I just bought it 3 days before that. And I really sat and thought about, what does a new car have that my car does not have? One is you get more power with smaller engines, which means better fuel economy for similar performance. That would be nice. You know, I could get 35 to 40 miles per gallon with similar horsepower, or even a little bit less horsepower, but a higher revving engine, and get similar performance. I might get something a little bit safer, but the Alero's a fairly safe car, especially for the year that was made. Quieter, that's one thing that definitely, newer cars are a lot quieter than older cars. They have a lot more sound deadening. The door, because of safety things, the glass is thicker, the doors are thicker, which makes it for a quieter car for the most part. And I know there's some cars that are new that aren't as quiet, but quieter cars. And the last thing is things like that are convenient. Steering wheel controls, Bluetooth, you know, steering wheel controls for the radio, Bluetooth, that sort of stuff. Well, some of those things, I can add an aftermarket and get all of that back. My Infiniti didn't have Bluetooth or an aux in or a USB port or MP3 compatibility. It had, you know, a 6-disc CD changer, but I could add the things I wanted in an aftermarket unit, which is something I can do with the Alero. I can add a lot of those things I want. As far as the quiet factor, I can't change the glass, but I could throw some Dynamat on the inside of the doors and on the floor under the carpet, and you know, if I really wanted to go that route. One reason why this car is so noisy is the tires on it are pretty terrible, and even though they have plenty of tread, I'll go over those in another video here shortly. The tires are actually a huge source of noise, and so going to a different tire will quiet it down significantly, so I'll get the quietness of it. The safety is, you know, something I can't change, but I definitely can be a safer driver, and be mindful of my driving. Like, I don't talk on my phone while I drive. I use the Bluetooth for audiobooks because I'm into the car so much, just listening to the radio isn't really something I like doing, because you listen to the same three songs over and over again. So, you know, I'm definitely satisfied with my purchase. You know, would I like a newer car? Oh yeah, definitely. You know, there's definitely some cars on my list that I'd love to own. V8 Mustang. I've always wanted a V8 Mustang. Convertible. I'd love a new convertible. But when you go to make that decision, write down what you're looking for. Write down your goals. Because if you go and buying a brand new car, make that decision yourself before you go into the dealer. It's not worth letting them make that decision for you. Make that decision yourself. You'll be much happier, a lot more satisfied. You won't have that buyer's regret. And used cars can be just as reliable as new cars. They can be just as fun. They can be just as nice as a new car. Shop around, know what you want. One thing that I definitely do that I recommend to anybody is become the expert. Know more about the car than the person selling you the car. Know more about the brand. Know more about the parts, the issues with the car. That's one nice thing about buying a used car is you can go online and see what kind of problems people are having with these things well in advance. But if I might make a recommendation, and I know a lot of people who watch this are going to disagree with me, but buy something you can pay cash for. Now, I bought this car so inexpensively. Like I said, I paid a little over $2,000 for it. I don't think this car will ever be worth less than $2,000. As long as it runs, as long as it has working AC in Arizona, as long as it shifts and I keep at least half decent tires and brakes on it, it's always going to be worth at least $2,000. So in, you know, that 2 to 3 year time frame, when I go to sell this, I'm going to make every penny back. Yes, I'm going to put money into maintenance and things like that on it, but I'm going to do that with any car. And I'm budgeting for that. I plan for that. But I'm also budgeting and planning for a car payment. I'm going to pay myself a car payment every month. And instead of going towards some bank and paying their interest and their fees, it's going to go into my bank and it's going to make me money. Now, it's not going to be as much as I'd make in a lot of other places, probably about 1% or so. But still, that's better than nothing and losing money. And in that 2 to 3 years time, I'm going to have a healthy chunk of money saved up. I'll be able to sell this for that same $2,000. Even if I sell it for $1,000, I'll be able to take that money plus the money I've saved up and buy something newer with less miles. And then every few years, you keep paying yourself that car payment. You work yourself up into a nicer car that you drive longer. And the longer you drive it, the more you keep putting that money aside, you're just going to be able to keep affording that nicer car. And it's something that I wish I'd done years ago. And so anybody who listens to this, if you go back and tell yourself one thing, if I could tell myself one thing about cars, I wish I'd been paying myself a car payment instead of paying it to the bank. I could have had nicer cars now, cash, paid for driving. Now, one thing I'm glad I didn't do is I drive the value off of them, so it's not worth doing it for that. But I could have had the money for when that day no longer exists, and then I'm buying cars and putting so many miles on them. But, you know, it's just something. So going back, logical choices. Take the emotion out of buying cars. When you go to the dealership, when you watch the ads, it's all about the emotions, because they know that emotions don't help you make good decisions. Especially the want. I want it. That is such a bad emotion to have when you're buying something. That's a little kid inside of you going, oh, I want it, I want it, I want it. And I have scratched that itch far too often and dug myself into a hole that has taken me over 8 years to dig out of. And I would not wish that on anybody. Maybe a few people, but for the most part, I wouldn't wish that on anybody. It has been off and on to the point of being hell to get out of that debt and to make my life what I wanted it to be and where it should have been years ago. And part of that is my decision to buy cars on time when I couldn't afford them. And now that I could afford those cars, I can't own them because I didn't save the money to buy them, because I was paying that money to a bank. So, I know it's kind of a long video. I don't know how many people are actually going to watch it. I know it's kind of boring because you're just looking at my car and listening to my voice. And watching all these cars drive by and the kids on their bikes coming home from school. It's a beautiful day. I live in Arizona because of days like this. I think it's probably in the mid-80s today. Sunny. Just gorgeous. And this car has zero rust on it. None at all. You look underneath and it looks like a brand new car. Anyways. Feel free to ask me any questions in the description below. Or in the shouldn't say description. In the comments below. I'll do my best to answer any questions you have. I've owned over 24 cars. So more than 24 cars I've owned. Most of those in the last 8 years. I lived out in a small town, Maricopa, is commuting to North Phoenix. I drove almost 200 miles a day just to get to and from work every single day. And I was working 6 days a week. Do the math. That's a lot of miles. And I lived 8 miles to the closest gas station, 10 miles to the closest grocery store. Doctor's office was 25, 30 miles away. Closest family was 40 miles away. Anything I did, anytime I ever did anything, I put a lot of miles on a car. And if you're doing that, don't buy a new car. Don't buy a newer car. Buy something you just don't care about because you're going to chew through it. It's not going to have any value in a short amount of time. I do have my Amazon and eBay partnership links. You find the link to those in the description. Find me on social media. I have a Facebook page for ASE Productions, for my different YouTube channels. Happy to discuss anything on there as well. Please like my page. Hopefully I can be more active on that. I do work a full-time job. My videos are not my full-time job. So I'm not as active as I'd like to be. So I know this kind of become a bit of a rant, a bit of discussion. But it feels good to just talk about some of these things. And hopefully that my decisions and my choices might help somebody else. That's the reason why I started doing these videos, is because I hope that one day I've helped somebody. I've been through a lot in my life, and I don't pretend to know everything. I don't pretend to have experienced everything, but I've definitely experienced a lot. And I have knowledge about cars. Like I said, I've owned a few of them. Definitely have had my favorites. I'm a huge Saab fan. I'm really sad when they went under, when GM let them go. Because I think they made a good product that was underrated, but that's just me. But again, thank you for watching. If you've made it to this point, congratulations. Hope you've learned something. And I hope you have a great day. Thank you.